Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. I am Farhan Ali from group GMM10. So today we will discuss about anti-allergic drugs. So let's start. Referred to as hypersensitivity. Hypersensitivity reactions are classified into four types. Type 1 reaction mediated by immunoglobulin E antibodies, allergy. Type 2 cytotoxic reactions mediated by immunoglobulin G or immunoglobulin M antibodies. Examples of type 2 HS include some forms of anemia, blood transfusion reaction, certain platelet disorder, and some types of tissue transplant rejection. Type 3 reaction mediated by immune complexes. Type 3 hypersensitivity is common in systemic lupus erythematosus SLE and underlies most of the pathophysiology of this chronic autoimmune disease. Type 4 delayed reaction mediated by cellular response. Two common examples of delayed hypersensitivity that illustrate the various consequences of type 4 reactions are tuberculin type and contact hypersensitivity. Agranulocytes. When an allergic reaction occurs, allergens bind to antibodies that the body produces called immunoglobulin E, IgE. Production of immunoglobulin E is activated by T helpers. Antibodies combat foreign and potentially harmful substances in the body. Once the allergen binds to immunoglobulin E, specific types of cells, including mast cells, will release chemicals that trigger the symptoms of the allergic reactions. Class of anti-allergic drugs. Antihistamines. Antihistamines used to treat allergy symptoms fall into two broad categories: sedating first generation and non-sedating second generation. The first category includes the older antihistamines. These allergy drugs relieve allergy symptoms but cause drowsiness and other side effects, including dry mouth. Newer antihistamines are said to be non-sedating, although some users may experience drowsiness even from these. Decongestants. These relieve a stuffy nose by constricting blood vessels, which limits the amount of secretions coming from the inner lining of the nose. Corticosteroids, leukotriene receptor antagonists, anti-leukotrienes. Leukotriene, one of the group of the chemicals produced by the body that accompanies inflammation. Leukotrienes are believed to play a major role in causing the symptoms of fever and asthma. Corticosteroids, budesonide, rinocort, fluticasone, furate, flonase, mometasone, nasonex, triamcinolone, nasacort, celecoxib, Zyung 0.1% strategy. It's a negative feedback. It is a fundamental control mechanism. Cortisol is the major glucocorticoid. In humans, it has two primary actions. It stimulates gluconeogenesis, the breakdown of protein and fat to provide metabolites that can be converted to glucose in the liver, and it activates anti-stress and anti-inflammatory pathways. It also has weak mineralocorticoid activity. So reaching adequate plasma concentration of cortisol and cortisone inhibits the secretion of adrenocorticotropic hormone ACTH from the adenohypophysis. Allergic immunotherapy, also known as desensitization or hyposensitization, is a medical treatment of environmental allergies such as insect bites and asthma. Immunotherapy involves exposing people to larger and larger amounts of allergens in an attempt to change the immune system's response. Allergy medication side effects. Older antihistamines are associated with drowsiness, dizziness, constipation, upset stomach, bloody vein, a dry mouth, nose and throat, a difficulty urinating. It means urine incompetency. The newer antihistamines are usually well tolerated but can cause drowsiness, dry mouth and stomach problems. Nasal corticosteroids can cause nasal dryness or irritation, nosebleed, throat irritation, headache, nausea, vomiting, cough and fungal infections of throat, which long term use Leukotriene inhibitors are associated with usual weakness and upset stomach, earache, dizziness, cough, headache, trouble sleeping. Serious but unlikely side effects include flu-like symptoms. Nasal decongestants may cause a temporary burning, staining or dryness in the nose or runny nose and sneezing. Oral decongestants may cause dizziness, headache, nervousness, fast heartbeat, increased blood pressure, hypertension, loss of appetite and sleep problems. Nasal anticholinergic can cause a bloody or dry nose, nasal congestion, dry mouth and irritated throat, bad taste in the mouth, dizziness and nausea. Topical corticosteroids for skin allergies can cause burning, itching, redness.